You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
We are gathered in God's name as God's people. Let us pray. May your grace, O Lord our God, we pray, at all times go before us and follow after us, and make us always determined to carry out good works. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, who are one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples a feast of rich food and choice wines, juicy, rich food and pure, choice wines. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from every face. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, "Behold, our God, to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord from whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us. For the hand of the Lord will rest on this mountain." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I shall leave the house of the Lord, all the living. Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, I know how to live in humble circumstances. I know also how to live with abundance. In every circumstance and in all things, I have learned the secret of being well fed and of going hungry, of living in abundance and of being in need. I can do all things in him who strengthens me. Still, it was kind of you to share in my distress. My God will fully supply whatever you need in accord with his glorious riches in Christ Jesus. To our God and Father, glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus again in reply spoke to the chief priests and elders of the people in parables, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who gave a wedding feast for his son. He dispatched his servants to summon the invited guests to the feast. They refused to come. A second time he sent other servants, saying, 'Tell those invited, behold, I have prepared my banquet, and calves and fat cattle are killed, and everything is ready. Come to the feast.' Some ignored the invitation and went away, one to his farm, another to his business. The rest laid hold of the servants, mistreated them, and killed them. The king was enraged and sent his troops, destroyed those murderers and burned the city. Then he said to his servants, 'The feast is ready, but those who were invited were not worthy to come. Go out therefore into the main roads and invite to the feast whoever you find.' The servants went out into the streets and gathered all they found, bad and good alike. The hall was filled with guests. But when the king came in to meet the guests, he saw a man there, not dressed in a wedding garment. The king said to him, 'My friend, how is it that you came in here without a wedding garment?' But he was reduced to silence. Then the king said to his attendants, 'Bind his hands and feet, and cast him into the darkness outside, where there will be wailing and grinding teeth. Many are invited, but few are chosen.' The gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
Again, Jesus speaks to chief priests and elders of the people. He wants them to clearly get the message he is teaching about the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God. The religious leaders, if they get it, then the people will get it. So Jesus tells another parable. Starting with a twist, starting with a point, just starting with a lesson that is to be learned for them and for us. This time,
The story is about a king giving a wedding banquet for his son. Truly a happy and joyous event that all would like to be part of. But the invited guests do not come, and they kill the messengers when the feast is ready to receive them. The king, enraged, has their city destroyed, and they are killed. But the king has his servants bring in others who will come to the banquet feast. They come from everywhere. They are the bad and they are the good. A strong message, to be sure, for all of us. Everyone is invited to the banquet of the Lord our God, our Father in heaven. And we need to hear that, ponder it in our hearts, know that it is meant for us, for those all around us, and those beyond us. God, the Father, Jesus, is still inviting us in love today to the banquet feast that he shares with us. It is for us to accept the invitation and to come to his feast. In the parable, though, one guest does not come dressed for the occasion. We don't know the reason why. Does he not have anything fitting to wear? Does he not know what he is supposed to wear? Does he not care what he is wearing? Is it a challenge that if the king is inviting everyone, he can just come as he is, and he doesn't have to prepare or get ready or be well-dressed? The guest, though, has clearly not responded with an open heart to the king and to the invitation. And so he is cast out because his own choice. We have choices in our life too. And so we grow in knowledge in order to make choices. We grow in wisdom, understanding, because of our own study, our own experience, our own interaction with other people. All of these things help us to respond by using our conscience and by using the virtue of prudence. Choices present themselves to us in our life. How will I respond? Conscience tells us, gather the facts as fully as you can. Ponder them too. Seek the advice of others who are trusted. Seek the advice of the church and its tradition. Use an open heart that is listening to God deep within us. In these days of the coronavirus, we would not go into a store or a public place without a mask fully covering our face and nose and mouth. Prudence tells us it is the right thing to do. In these days of a national election, prudence and conscience guide us also in the profound decision of our vote. Reflect on the social teachings of the church and the tradition of the church. We are invited today to the rich banquet of the Lord, which is this Eucharistic celebration. May we come with a humble yet converted heart, eager to receive our God, who is Father, God, who is Son, Jesus Christ, and God, the Holy Spirit. Let us truly receive the distress and pressures of the present day. May we know the strength of God and the support of family, of friends, of co-workers. Together we profess what we believe. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things was created. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, who was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and he became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is the Lord and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I profess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With confidence, we offer these prayers to our merciful and compassionate God.
For Francis, our Pope, and Leonard, our Bishop, may the unity of the Church and peace of Christ be seen in the universe today. Let us pray to the Lord. For our president and all world leaders to be safe and healthy in these days of pandemic, to govern for the common good of all, let us pray to the Lord. For an abundant harvest, a generous heart satisfy the hungry and the thirsty, let us pray to the Lord. For those who have lost a loved one because of the coronavirus, for those who have tested positive, may all of us follow the safety guidelines and work to stem the virus. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for Ula, Abe, Carly, for being baptized this weekend. May God bless them and their families. Let us pray to the Lord. For peace in the world, for those who have died by violence, for those suffering from wildfires and hurricanes, for those who suffer religious persecution, especially Christians in Middle East countries, let us pray to the Lord. For the members of our parish who are sick and hospitalized, for those who are confined to home, no longer worship with us, and for those who have died, John of New Jersey, today's Mass being offered for Dominic Sheehan, let us pray to the Lord. For our own personal intentions, those who resonated with hope, and all those with an ancient prayer room, let us pray to the Lord.
Generous and loving God, you lavish your bounty on creation, which is then for all people. In your spirit, may we share your mercy and blessings with them. We ask this in the name of Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Accept, O Lord our God, the prayers of your faithful people with these sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotion we may pass to the glory of heaven with you. Through Christ our Lord. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Holy Father, Lord of heaven and earth, through Christ our Lord. For by your word you created the world, and you governed all things in harmony. You gave us your word made flesh as our mediator, and he has spoken your words to us and called us to follow him. For he is the way that leads to you, the truth that sets us free, the life that fills us with gladness. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the angels and saints, we proclaim your glory and in joyful celebration acclaim. History of faith. Led through his passion and death on the cross, to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. And we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of all blessing. Look with favor on the offering of your church, in which we show forth paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of your Spirit of love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking of this mystery, Almighty God and Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son, and confirm us in the bond of communion. Together with Francis, our Pope, Leonard, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people, grant that the faithful of the Church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the Gospel. Keep us attentive to the needs of all people, that sharing their grief and their pain, their joy and their hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and go forward with them along the way of your kingdom. Remember our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs and all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Christ Jesus, your Son. And through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. most humbly, O Lord our God, that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, so you may make us sharers of his divine nature, for he lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Would you please be seated? Our first announcement at the end of Mass today is going to concern the Knights of Columbus, and I would ask Mike to come forward for that. Thank you.
Thank you, Monsignor. So, my name is Mike DiCicora. I live, you don't know me. We've been parishioners here for a little over 23 years now. My wife and I and my daughter is up at school at this point. Some of you may remember her from a little baby. But yes, she's 20 years old now. I'm a member of the Knights of Columbus. Been a member since we founded the council here in 2008. You may know some other members already throughout the parish who are members. You may also have family, friends, relatives who are members of other councils. Who make up nearly 2 million members of Knights of Columbus worldwide. As Knights, we serve our parish and community while working each day to create a better world through charity. If you are looking to live out your faith in the spirit of charity by helping others, our Knights of Columbus welcomes you to join us. Knights and their families, it's never just Knights, it's always the families that are there to support and help out and participate as well, have the opportunity to become involved in our council's charitable, faith-based, and social programs. Over the past decade, Knights of Columbus families worldwide have enabled the charitable donations of the Knights of Columbus to reach more than $1.5 billion, and individual Knights have donated more than 700 million volunteer hours to charity. Since its founding in 1882, by the way, right down the road in New Haven, Connecticut, at St. Mary's Church, Knights of the Venerable Servant of God, Father Michael J. McGivney, soon to be blessed, will be beatified on Halloween, on October 31st. The first principle of order has always been charity. With this principle as our guide, our council strives to actively assist the church and our neighbors in need. We would like to offer the opportunity to join us in our work for God and neighbor. Our council has undertaken many activities that benefit. We are second live council meeting, if you will. It's not this coming Monday, it's next Monday, October 19th. We'll be downstairs in the Donnelly Parish Center. We also will be doing Zoom meetings, so if those of you who are not comfortable coming in person, we ask that you inquire and a link can be provided there. And again, we can enroll in person or virtually as well. So again, we faithfully ask you to consider not living out your faith alone, but joining the Knights and helping us further Christ's message. Thank you.
Thank you, Mike. A reminder that today, this morning, we had two sessions for our first communions. There were some about 35 young people that received communion for the first time. So please keep them and their families.